Cove Care Center, Counseling and Wellness Management.
Our son started getting in trouble. I thought we could handle it.
Our granddaughter was becoming withdrawn. We didn't know what to do.
Cove Care's Family Peer Support Service advocates have been in your shoes. At no cost, they'll come to you to answer questions and connect you to support and resources.
We realized it's okay to get extra support. I'm so glad we reached out to Cove Care.
They helped us help our granddaughter.
Cove Care Center offers counseling that empowers change. We are here to help. CoveCare Center, counseling and wellness management.
I lost my job. My family fell apart. My drinking took over.
I felt like a sinking ship and just kept numbing my pain with pills.
Healing and recovery are possible. At CoveCare, we focus on the whole person and help get you and your loved ones on the road to recovery.
CoveCare helped me break the cycle and slowly rebuild my life.
My counselor taught me healthy ways to cope.
CoveCare Center offers counseling that empowers change. We are here to help. CoveCare Center, Counseling and Wellness Management.
My son was acting different. I was concerned he had a drug problem.
My wife's drinking was getting worse. I didn't know what to do.
CoveCare's Family Support Navigator program comes to you to answer questions and connect you to resources for treatment, counseling, and support.
Now I feel informed and know where to turn for help.
Thanks to CoveCare, my wife found treatment and I found support.
CoveCare Center offers counseling that empowers change. We are here to help.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome to CoveCare Center's first virtual Imagine event. Wherever you're tuning in from, we thank you for taking the time to be with us for this special night. We have several goals here this evening. The first is to raise awareness to make sure you know what CoveCare is all about and what it is that we do. The second, of course, is to raise funds. There will be opportunities throughout the evening to give. And of course, our silent auction is currently live. Don't forget to check it out. Most importantly, though, is to stay connected, which is the theme of tonight's event. COVID did its best to interfere with our connection to the community, but as you will learn tonight, we remain as connected as ever to our clients, to our mission, and to all of you. Of course, there are people to thank here tonight, the first and foremost of which are the team at CoveCare, whose work and dedication kept us strong through the pandemic, our clients who remain committed to their recovery, and of course, our amazing board of directors. Several of those folks you will hear from this evening. We've also got some tremendous sponsors whose names you will see on your screen. And last but not least, Joseph Roberto, Chairman and CEO of PCSB Bank and our honoree for the evening. CoveCare Center is the only not-for-profit behavioral health organization offering such a wide range of services to the residents of Putnam County. Tonight, we hope that you will learn a bit more about what we do and the impact we have on the community here in Putnam and in the Lower Hudson Valley. Our focus on staying connected means offering services to people where they're at. It means being part of the community as much as it means supporting that community. And that means being part of a team. From our staff, to our board, to our clients, to our sponsors, we are all connected and we are all a team. That's what it means to be connected, and that's what it means to be CoveCare Center. We are here tonight to move our organization forward, to increase our ability to make an impact. That means raising funds to support our mission, but it also means reminding our community that we are here. We've been here. We're here when you need us. If you have a substance use or mental health challenge, whether you're a child, a teenager, a parent, a senior, we're here to help. If you have a child who's struggling with anxiety, we're here. If you're feeling overwhelmed, we're here to help. If you or your spouse is struggling, we're here to help. Reach out. We are here. Connect with us, because when we are connected, the magic can happen.
When we are connected, the magic can happen. Imagine a community connected. And that's just what we are tonight, with people tuning in from near and far. Eric, thank you for getting us started. So we aren't able to gather in person this year, but we are going to keep our community connected through this video presentation. Hi, I'm Kacey from Mike and Kacey in the Morning on 100.7 WHUD. And I am also a huge fan of CoveCare. Now, I'm here tonight with staff members and board members and those who have benefited from the programs at CoveCare. We're here to connect with you, and we're here to celebrate our honoree, Mr. Joseph Roberto of PCSB Bank and the PCSB Foundation. Congratulations, Joe. We're looking forward to hearing from you a little bit later on. Now, throughout the presentation, you can text in your support to the number you see on the screen. And thank you to those who have already donated to our 2021 Imagine event. Please take a look at our e-journal, because we want you to see all of the organizations that support CoveCare. And we can connect right now through the chat. We'd love to see your reactions throughout the presentation. So as Eric said, we're here to connect, we're here to raise awareness, and we're here to raise funds for CoveCare's mental health, substance use, and emotional support programs. Especially in these unprecedented times, we need your support. As Eric mentioned, CoveCare never closed its doors through the worst days of the pandemic. All of the nurses and the social workers and the psychiatrists, even the front office staff, everyone worked together for CoveCare's mission. Now, CoveCare partners with families and individuals and the community. CoveCare restores the quality of life by addressing mental health needs and substance use and social and emotional issues. Now we're going to learn more about CoveCare from Michael Piazza, the Commissioner of Mental Health, Social Services, and the Youth Bureau in Putnam County.
I had been in and out of hospitals since I was 17. A few years ago, I found CoveCare Center, and everything changed. The people there picked me up and taught me the skills I needed to cope with my conditions.
Losing my job turned my life upside down. I turned to drinking and drugs to cope, and they had taken over my life. I needed treatment to get my life and health back on track. And CoveCare Center, they were there for me. Now 12 months sober, I have a new job and a new outlook on life.
When we first came to CoveCare Center, we were a family in crisis. Our child's behavior was challenging us all, and we have tried everything to help. At CoveCare Center, we found the help we need and support from a welcoming network of families like ours.
Life hasn't been the same since my wife passed. I'd become isolated and depressed. The visits I receive from counselors from CoveCare Center make me feel like myself again. Thanks to them, I'm on my way to rebuilding my health and my outlook on life.
CoveCare Center fosters hope, healing, and wellness. From mental health counseling to alcohol and substance use treatment, from services that strengthen the family to helping you manage complex health conditions, we are your partner in recovery.
Hello. I am Mike Piazza, Commissioner of the Putnam County Departments of Mental Health, Social Services, and the Youth Bureau. Today is my pleasure to support CoveCare Center on its 24 years of service to Putnam County and to commemorate all that CoveCare does for our county through its virtual, at this time of its virtual Imagine Gala. Excuse me. For 24 years, CoveCare Center has contributed to the health of our community through its licenses with the Office of Mental Health and the Office of Substance Abuse Services. Today, CoveCare Center is as valuable as ever. Just this week, the staff of CoveCare addressed the needs of a school district who needed crisis intervention services, and they helped the county in addressing that issue. In addition, CoveCare proposes to establish a crisis respite program for children, and we're hopeful that the Office of Mental Health will approve that very soon. But wait, there's more. CoveCare has proven its willingness to serve by being a grantee for the Rapid Rehousing Grant through the Office of Disability and Temporary Assistance, not necessarily something that was in their charter. However, insofar as mental health consumers and substance abuse consumers of services who are homeless are now receiving apartments through the work of the staff of CoveCare Center, it is a very important part of the community. And in addition, CoveCare is able to draw down state funds to be able to help fund our winter shelter and our warming center. And that's very important. In the new year, Putnam County and all of its law enforcement jurisdictions will begin a mobile tablet crisis intervention program. Officers in the field who come into contact with someone having a mental health or substance abuse crisis will have access to a crisis intervention counselor at CoveCare and be able to, through telehealth, be able to address the issue and provide an extra needed level of support to the officer. And as we continue to enhance our crisis response, hopefully for a crisis stabilization center and for mobile crisis in the future, the involvement of CoveCare will be very, very important to that end. So I congratulate Eric, Lisa, all of the staff at CoveCare who have worked so hard with us, and the board of directors, and thank you all for the service you provide for the people of Putnam. Congratulations, and thanks again.
It's been wonderful to have CoveCare Center in our community, that's a place when we're doing the work we're doing to combat stigma and raise awareness and let people know that recovery is possible, that they have a place where they can go to actually start working on their path on that road. Because of the prevalence of stigma, when you're breaking down those barriers and people finally do go to get care, they're going to get it. They're not going to run into a barrier because they don't have insurance, or because they're underinsured, or because they don't have access to transportation. CoveCare has a variety of different services that can wrap themselves around the individual rather than, you know, expecting the individual to meet a very specific category to be eligible to get the care that they need.
We are a community connected. Thank you, Megan Castellano. She's the executive director of the Mental Health Association in Putnam, a CoveCare affiliate. We thank her for reminding us that no one is turned away at CoveCare. You can get the help you need. And as Commissioner Piazza pointed out, CoveCare has been contributing to the health of the community for 24 years. From schools to crisis and respite, to crisis respite and response, to helping find housing for those in need. We'd love to feel your support tonight. So please text CoveCare to the number you see on the screen, 833-562-0429. Make a donation right now in any amount. And again, we thank all of our sponsors. Your support is greatly appreciated. And now we're going to say hello to Melissa Marino, the program director of CoveCare's PROS program. And we've been lucky to have Melissa with us since 2007.
Thank you for giving me the time to share a snippet about PROS. My name is Melissa, and I'm the director of the PROS program, and I have been so for many years. PROS stands for Personalized Recovery Oriented Services. It's a rehabilitation program for adults diagnosed with serious mental health conditions who hope to work on developing meaningful life roles for themselves. Some of these include vocational endeavors, such as getting a job, part-time job, volunteering, returning to school to increase their education, physical wellness, developing independence, fostering relationships, learning healthy coping skills so that they can lead the lives that they have chosen. Our participants work together with our interdisciplinary team of rehab specialists to achieve their goals. Over the past 2 years, we have functioned on a hybrid model where all of our groups right now are virtual and on Zoom, and it has been wonderful to connect our participants in a time where connecting wasn't always easy. And we do have some people that we obviously see in person as well. I'm going to introduce Michael, who will speak a little bit more about how PROS has helped him through these past many years and how we have fostered connections with each other. So again, thank you so much. And thank you, Michael, for joining us today.
My name is Mike Bulger. I'm 68 years old, and I've been living in Brewster for about 7 years by the way of the Bronx. I grew up in the Bronx during the 60s and 70s, and it was really a great time. Unfortunately, some bad things happened that I really couldn't cope with. So you look to drugs to cope with these things. Drugs did help me cope, but at the time, it also took away my heart and soul. For a long time, I was living what we call at PROS a cycle of suffering, where it just kept going round and round. Fortunately, on April Fool's Day, 1996, I used heroin for the last time. I absolutely thought my life would be perfect, but it was far from it. Nightmares, panic attacks. I just didn't know what to do because the drugs were masking all these feelings that I had. My mom, after I got clean, my mom got quite sick. So I threw myself into caring for her And then also at that time, I got a job. So I concentrated on my mother and my job and not on me. Anything, as long as I didn't have to do anything where I had to look at myself, I was okay. And that went on for quite a while until my mom passed away in September of 2012. That's when, I guess you can say, the walls came tumbling down. I was a total loss. I didn't know what to do. And lo and behold, I wound up at Putnam Family Community Services. That's what it was called back then. Now it's CoveCare. And I wound up in the PROS program. And I say this with all sincerity and from the bottom of my heart, PROS saved my life. It gave me a drive to find myself, because I did not know what I was. But was I an addict? Was I a caregiver? I didn't know. I had no identity. PROS gave me one through the groups that I took, through the great people running the groups. Through PROS, I was able to become a peer specialist by taking courses, and also then went on to become a recovery coach for substance abuse and a mental health recovery coach. And I work for MHA in Putnam County, which is a job that I love and that I never thought I would have. And basically, I've got that through what I've learned at PROS. And everything was going well at PROS. Everything was good until that date of March 16th, 2020, when Melissa called me and said, no groups because of the pandemic. We'll let you know, later in the week, you know, what we're going to do and what's going on. Needless to say, that week was just was like a week from hell. I was lost. I didn't know what to do. Fortunately, that Friday, I get another call from Melissa, and she tells me, we're going to do a phone group. Are you interested? I said, hell yeah. You know, we'll be doing groups over the phone, she said. And, you know, I didn't know how it was going to go. It was a little weird in the beginning, but then it just became normal PROS stuff, which means it's great. And then Zoom was added to it, and it became even better. And, you know, during the pandemic, you know, things became extremely hard, not only for me, but it's fair to say for everyone. And the PROS team, I'm talking about the staff from Eric on down, have been there for us. I say us, I mean the community, the PROS community, have been there since day one when this pandemic hit. And I don't know where I'd be or what I'd be doing without going to my groups 3 days a week. I work 2 days a week, so I have a full week. I have to see my therapist. It's just, you know, PROS didn't skip a beat. Yes, we're not there face-to-face, you know, in our group rooms, but we're still there. We're still a community. We're still whole. We're still working hard. We're still healing with each other. And that's a great thing. And all I can say is from the bottom of my heart, thank you, everyone at PROS.
We're still healing. together. We are a community connected. Michael, thank you so much for sharing your heart and your story with us. That was so powerful. And Melissa, thank you for telling us all about the PROS program. So remember, all the proceeds from tonight's program, they benefit, support, and support CoveCare's mission and programs like PROS. And these programs reach across our community and into homes. And on that note, we've got a big shout out to Joe DiMarzo. Hey, Joe, thank you for your very generous donation of $500. Amazing. Thank you, Joe. And thank you to everyone who's using the chat this evening. We appreciate your enthusiasm. So you see the number on your screen. You can text right now, CoveCare, to 833-562-0429. We really would love to hear from you. And now we're going to take a look at peer support. With help from a CoveCare consumer and our own Amanda Bocardi, the Children's Services Coordinator and Peer Advocate.
I'm healthier and stronger now because of coming to CoveCare Center, because they've treated me as a whole human being. They've addressed my mental challenges in physical ways with medication, in psychological ways with therapy, in vocational ways with becoming employable and getting back into the workforce and the community. And also, they've helped me to learn to love myself despite any of my challenges. That, I think, is the most important thing, just to learn to love yourself and realize that you can succeed in whatever you set out to do.
My name is Amanda Bocardi. I am a youth peer advocate at CoveCare Center. So what I do is I provide peer support to children and adolescents. And this focuses a lot on self-advocacy and effective communication, and really just being able to, identify their needs and speak up for themselves around them. It also provides systems navigation. So what peer support is the sharing of lived experience, right? And it provides hope, support, and just this idea that you're really not alone in the difficulties you might be facing in life. You know, I think oftentimes it feels a lot like no one understands us or what we've gone through, what we're going through at the moment. So being able to really hear from others who have similar experiences as us, you know, everyone's journey is their own, right? Everyone's experiences are theirs. But being able to hear from someone who maybe have overcome their own experiences and are working through recovery themselves, it gives us this non-judgmental space. And we're really able to just open up, ask questions, we can share stories, and really just listen to and learn from one another. What's really incredible about peer support too is, in addition to this type of emotional support and feedback, it also offers assistance in systems navigation of both the mental health and substance use systems. And, you know, I think sometimes this can really feel very overwhelming, right? We may not know who to call or what direction to go in. It really just offers this type of guidance through the systems from someone who has been through it themselves. So you can share things like what has worked for me, what hasn't worked for me, and, you know, try this, this might work for you. And really just being able to have that support and guidance through something that really can seem a little bit overwhelming and confusing. So peer support actually originally came about following the mental health consumer movement, and this took place in the 1970s. So CoveCare has been in operation since 1997, and we have been providing peer support since then. We offer it today across all of our services to people of all ages who are really just looking to connect with individuals who are in recovery from mental health and substance use struggles. So, you know, what we're here talking about is this community connected, right? And connectedness is something that we have all learned the importance of, if we didn't know it before, in its recent absence due to the pandemic, right? So as humans, I truly believe that we are just built to connect with other human beings. After so many conversations I've had with so many different people over recent months, I know I can speak for many when I say it's something's connectedness that we are really all just longing for. So what is so incredible about peer support is it not only provides this human connection, but it also really allows us to identify with other people and, create this community. with such a unique understanding of one another. And, you know, it gives us this sense of belonging and connectedness with others who, you know, we feel we can identify with. And that really is just so invaluable and so powerful.
Thank you, Amanda. And thank you, Kate. We are a community connected. And you can see that CoveCare helps people of all ages and in many different ways. CoveCare is a nonprofit organization. CoveCare relies on the support of the community to be able to present vital programs. So let's take a look at some of the examples of how your donation could serve the community. A $1 donation could help provide a weekly group for family support. A $750 donation could help two parents or caregivers participate in a step parenting course. $500 could provide taxi rides for clients to attend a job interview or go to support groups. $250 could provide supervised visits for parents with children in foster care. A $100 donation could provide art supplies for our therapeutic children's room and garden supplies for our therapeutic garden. $50 could help purchase backpacks and school supplies for our young clients. Every donation means so much. And speaking of donations, thank you, Cassandra Thayer. Cassandra just made a $250 donation. So text CoveCare to 833-562-0029. Now we are going to hear from the Vice Chair of CoveCare's Board of Directors, Anita Manella, and she's going to introduce our honoree.
Thank you, Kacey. The Imagine Award was created in 2014 to recognize Sid Gibson for his years of support as a community ambassador and benefactor. He steadfastly believed in a community free from stigma for those facing mental health and substance use issues. Sid's legacy continues today with an individual whose positive impact on our community defies imagination. The 2021 Imagine Award is presented tonight to a man of integrity and value, Mr. Joe Roberto. Joe works every day to ensure that all of us in our community continue not only to thrive, but to excel. Shortly, you'll learn more about the podcast program, a program initially funded by and still supported by PCSB Bank. This program has flourished through the direct support and encouragement of tonight's honoree. The podcast program empowers youth to lead healthier lives, pursue more educational opportunities, and opens new doors for their future. Ladies and gentlemen, not all superheroes wear capes and fly through the night sky. Our superhero wears a business suit and is deeply connected to our community. It is my privilege at this time to present the 2021 Imagine Award to Mr. Joseph Roberto.
Good evening. I am overwhelmed with gratitude to join you this evening to receive the CoveCare Center Sid Gibson Imagine Award. It is an honor to have the work of PCSB Bank and our community foundation be recognized in this way, and truly gratifying to know that our support is making a difference. At PCSB, we have tremendous respect for the CoveCare Center and the important work they are doing to address mental health needs, substance use, and social and emotional issues. As we all know, the COVID-19 pandemic has created significant challenges, and we've all had to make adjustments to how we navigate the new normal. And I can tell you that knowing some of the adjustments that CoveCare has had to make, I must recognize the steadfast commitment of the executive and program staff, as well as the board of directors. They ensure that vital resources were and still are being provided to all communities throughout the Lower Hudson Valley. That's why I'm here tonight, along with you, supporting their important work. As one of the premier local community banks serving the Lower Hudson Valley, PCSB is committed to improving the quality of life for everyone in our area. Through our community foundation, we provide essential support to many worthwhile organizations like CoveCare Center. Neighbors helping neighbor is the definition of community banking, and it is something that will always remain a priority for PCSB Bank. As we continue working through the pandemic recovery toward better days ahead, let's all reflect on how amazing things can happen when we all pull together and work toward a common goal. And that goal is to respect each other, take care of each other, and make sure that no one is left behind. That is what community is all about from the inside out. On behalf of all of us at PCSB Bank and our community foundation, I extend special thanks to Eric Toth and the entire CoveCare Center team for this recognition. We share your vision for a world where all people are valued, accepted, and empowered to live healthy lives. I hope you will continue to enjoy the evening's programming and stay safe.
Congratulations, Joe, and thank you for all you do to make a difference and for all you do to promote respect, acceptance, and empowerment for all. And that award looks really great on your desk. Now, as we've heard, PCSB Bank and the PCSB Community Foundation have been wonderful supporters of a program we all love, and that's the Youth Podcast. So now let's see what it's all about and meet the producers, Brandon Lillard and Messiah Henry. This is a special glimpse into how young people are staying connected.
What is your wish, young child?
I want to connect with people.
Your wish will be answered when you see the golden feather.
We here at CoveCare Center were able to continue our podcast program throughout the COVID-19 pandemic. We were able to continue the program via Zoom, other video teleconferencing services like Discord. It was a good opportunity for the kids to, one, stay connected with each other, especially during that time when everyone was isolated. The podcast was a space for the kids to still kind of stay connected with their peers who might have been in other schools, other parts of the county. For me, as a staff, it brought me a lot of peace of mind in being able to have some sort of normalcy and still engaging with the young people that I've been working with in the podcast program. Throughout our experience, we got to explore the different avenues of podcasting and also got us into doing more video-based content as well, too, simply off of being on Zoom. It created an opportunity for the kids to really kind of explore their interests as well as develop a lot of their skills.
The podcast program has had a huge impact on my life and the people around me. Before I was introduced to the podcast program, I was a social outcast and not seen by many in the high school that I attended, and I didn't really do much with my free time living with my family. Since then, when the podcast program was introduced to me, I got to meet a lot of people and expand my skills. Not only that, but I got to share my creativity with the different people around me, and it was a wonderful experience. Being a part of a podcast allowed me to travel to different communities and get to hear their story and hear their piece of the world, what their personal experiences was. And that's something I didn't get to see compared to watching television or staring at magazines and playing video games all day. It's a very real experience to get to talk to someone.
Hey dude, welcome to the podcast. Come on in.
Don't just stand at the door, come in. Hey, you want to see my cool keychain?
Sure.
My dad gave it to me for my birthday.
Awesome. Just awesome. We love it. Thanks, Brandon and Messiah, for your inspiration and talent. And thanks to everyone who works on the podcast. Sharing your story and your creativity. It's changing lives. And this podcast is keeping kids connected, especially over the last 20 months. And thanks again to PCSB Bank for supporting this program from the very beginning. So now we'd like you to listen in as a parent shares her experience with the CoveCare Parenting Program.
Good evening. I'm here to thank CoveCare for offering this parenting class. This class was given by Wanda Crowley. As a parent, I'm always looking for tools and techniques to use when dealing with my child. In this class, I use many of those techniques and could use them on a daily basis. Even with all the support I have from my family, I'm still looking to learn more. In this class, it was helpful to hear the stories from other parents who were struggling too. It made me realize I was not alone in this world. Having Wanda as our instructor, with all her knowledge and experience, made it a lot easier to talk about issues because she knew what we were going through. She would say, we are all good parents because of what we're doing for our children. After the first session, I could tell that we were going to learn a lot of techniques and tools to use on our children. And here are a few of these techniques that I use on my child. Giving choices. I feel by giving choices, the child's still in control, and that's what he's looking for. I also, another tool is remain calm when speaking with them. I know it's very hard, but when you're yelling and they're yelling, you're just fueling their fire and that's what they're looking for. So if you can have a nice calm voice, that works. Use reflective listening. Listen to what your child has to say. They do have a lot to say, and by listening, you can hear what they're looking for or what they need. I use iMessages also. I let them know how I feel. I'm very disappointed how you acted today. I'm very happy that you did well in your school today. Making good choices, supporting them making good choices and bad choices with the consequences. They need to know that their choice was good or their choice was bad, and this is the consequences that follow it. I also use praise and encouragement. Whenever I get the opportunity, I praise my child for what he's done. I encourage him to try things that he hasn't, just so that he knows what it's all about. And I've created realistic goals that your child can accomplish. In the past, I have done goals that my child would never have accomplished. So after learning that you need to have realistic goals for them, it does work a lot better. And there's a quote that I would like you to hear. No child is bad. They just make bad choices. And that is so true. I use that all the time. And to end it, so if there are any parents out there who feel the need to learn new tools and techniques to help with their children, this course may be for you. And remember, you're not alone.
You're not alone. We are a community connected. What a beautiful message. What a beautiful lesson. And what a wonderful experience it's been for me tonight to help share part of the CoveCare story with you. Thank you for watching. Thank you again to our sponsors. Thank you to everyone who is donating and bidding on the auction. You can find the link in the chat. And now it is my pleasure and honor to introduce you to my friends, the board chair of CoveCare, Stacy Gibson.
Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Stacy Gibson, and I'm very proud to serve as chair of the board of CoveCare Center. And on behalf of the board, we hope that you gained some insight into this amazing agency and got to know some of the dedicated people that work tirelessly every single day to keep our community safe and healthy. But we could never do this work without the generous support of you. And from the bottom of our hearts, we thank you so very, very much. But please don't leave just yet. The night is still young. We hope you'll join us for our grand finale. It will be so much fun. And just remember, when we're connected, the magic really does happen.
When you're connected, love happens.
When we're connected, we have community strength.
When we're connected, we all feel better.
When we are connected, we can make a difference.
When we are connected, we are uplifted.
When we're connected, we have a foundation.
When we're connected, we won't fear isolation.
When we're connected, everybody's smiling, laughing, and having a great time.
When we're connected, magic happens.
When we're connected, good things happen.
When we are connected, we are accountable.
When we're connected, we all feel safe to learn and grow.
When we're connected, I can be my best self. When we're connected, imagination and creativity are endless.
Good evening. When you're connected, all life's challenges seem easier and obstacles are best viewed through the rearview mirror.
When we're connected, things just feel better.
When we're connected, we are not alone.
When we are connected,
we are a team.
When we are connected, we help families heal.
When we're connected, I feel good.
When we're connected, we feel strong.
Good night.
Bye-bye.